Hey you, I'm Sarah Turner. I'm a freelance medical copywriter, and today I want to talk to you about how facts tell but stories sell. How incorporating storytelling in your copywriting is going to make you a more effective copywriter. And there are a lot of reasons as to why this is true. First of all, just us as humans, we prefer to hear stories over reading a list of facts about something. So anytime I'm writing a piece of copy and I'm describing features or benefits of something, I always go back through and I think, where in here can I tell a little story to kind of explain the use of the product or the service and what the end result might look like for my prospective, customer? So the other reason that this is super important is because it helps fire what's called mirror neurons in the brain. And mirror neurons are, something that happens. It's because we're empathetic creatures. And it's what happens when, you see somebody who's feeling really sad or having a sad day. Maybe they're crying. And maybe immediately you notice that and you get a little sad too because you feel bad for them and you empathize with whatever it is they're going through, even if you don't know what it is. So when you tell stories, you have a lot of more opportunity to effectively, convey emotions, paint an end picture of what their life might be like if they sign up for your program or buy your product. And it just works. We receive it a lot better as people. So this is a great thing about copywriting because sometimes people think, they love to do creative writing and they think that will copywriting be enough of that for an outlet for them? And it really can if you do it well and you incorporate storytelling. The other thing is, I don't really consider myself a very creative person. I came from a science background. And so the whole creative aspect of storytelling was something that didn't necessarily come very natural for me. I was much more, writing research related things and telling facts and focusing on like the rational side of things. So it was definitely a practice for me to start incorporating stories into my copy, but it eventually becomes more fun as a copywriter when you tell stories, and it's more effective. So really working on incorporating stories, and they can be small. They don't need to be a long, grand story. It can just be a quick two sentences about something that happened with somebody who used your product or service. And it also allows you to relate to people so they understand that you know what they're going through, that you are actually reaching the right person. Because if you can tell a story that somebody thinks, oh my gosh, that same exact thing happens to me, it's just going to be so effective. So one of the best story telling strategies you can use is a hero's journey. And there are a lot of people who talk about this. The hero's journey is a very standard template that movies use and books use. And basically, a good example would be Harry Potter or Lord of the Rings. You have your hero, which would be Harry Potter or Frodo, and they are going through a process that's difficult and hard, and there are challenges and there are enemies and there are bad guys and there are personal things going on that they have to work through, and they have a guide. And so that guide would be Dumbledore or Gandalf, and those guides are the wise people in the story who kind of help the hero along in their journey. So what you can do when you're doing that, you always want to make your audience the hero. So they are the Harry Potter, they are the Frodo, and they're the ones going through the tough stuff, and you're relating to them and saying, I get it here, and then you and your product or your service are the guide. So you are the Dumbledore, you are the Gandalf. And I really love that image when I'm, writing copy, because it allows me to think about, how can I support my audience or my customer, my client? And what is that product or service that I'm selling really do to help them along in their journey? So it's a really effective tool. We're all really used to it because, when we go to movies, that's what we want to see. We want to see the hero come out on top. We want to see them win. We want to see them overcome adversity and feel like champions. And so you can always, with whatever product or service you're using, for the most part, come up with a way to incorporate the hero's journey. And a really good book on this is Story Brand by Donald Miller, I believe. It's a pretty like well-known book as far as, you know, in copywriting and content writing, as far as really digging into the detail of the hero's journey. Because the other benefit about using storytelling is so people love to say, actually, that our attention spans are getting shorter, but actually studies don't show that that's true. They're about the same, but what's happening is we have a competition for attention. You know, people now have iPhones and Netflix, and they're walking down the street and they're getting bombarded with ads, and we just have so much more media in general. You know, the TV's on when you're getting your hair done, or like just everywhere you go, you're being bombarded by the media, by ads. And so it's not necessarily that people's attention span are getting shorter. It's that there's more competition for people's attention. I mean, think about it. Movies are so much longer than they used to be in general. We've always had some really long movies that were considered classics. But in general, you know, some of the Marvel movies are like 3 hours long. And people love them and they go to them. So that tells us that our attention spans are not getting shorter. We just want to be entertained a little better. So really incorporating storytelling is going to help you with that. And then I really want to talk about, is it okay to ever fabricate a story for the sake of an article or a sales page? And I'm going to go ahead and say no, because the thing is people really have, you know, we're much more educated. We are come across so much more information than the people, like people 10, 20, 50 years ago. And so I believe, one, it's dishonest. And there are so many good stories that you can actually find that are based in reality. But two, I also think that you run the risk of alerting the client, customer, you know, prospective audience person. You run the risk of really alerting their bullshit radar or alarm when you use a fake story. Because sometimes they can feel too good to be true, or they're not hitting the right points, or they're just... all the elements and details in a story that, you know, are specific to somebody's real experience, they don't go perfectly according to plan. So often when I'm reading a piece of copy where somebody's fabricated a story, I can tell because it's too perfect to, you know, explain the benefits of their product or service. And it just sounds off that bullshit alarm where you're like, that's not a real story. And then they don't trust you. And as soon as your reader doesn't trust you, you've lost. So it is so worth taking the time to really dig out a real story. And as a copywriter, that is your job. You should never be afraid to go to a client and say, hey, I would love to interview your customers. I would love to do a survey. Surveys are one of the most valuable, you know, pieces of information collecting you can do as a copywriter, because you can think, and your client, especially when they're really close to their product, you guys might think you know what people are looking for and their pain points. But as soon as you run that survey, I can't tell you the number of times that I've run a survey and the results and the responses that we got back, we were like, wow, okay, you know, let's shift our focus a little bit to really address the needs of people. I've even helped my client create a program for her audience. And when we ran the survey first before we started creating the program, and our minds were blown that these people who, you know, are really successful in their careers and stuff, and the thing that they were looking for the most was a community. So what we did was we started, when we were building the program, we started building it around this community that they need. And that was not something that we, either one of us, expected. We thought they would want facts. We thought they would want data. We thought they would want research. And that was the direction we were going. And if we hadn't taken that survey, we wouldn't have had, you know, all that information. The other thing is all the information you get back from surveys allows you to tell stories. So some of the stories people told us in the surveys, because we left it really open-ended, you know, we incorporated that in our copy, and it becomes a story that we can use when, you know, we're marketing this program, but it's an actual, true, authentic story. And again, getting really specific and picking up on the details of the story and making sure, you know, you're not just saying like really when you're talking in a story, you don't want to say something like, he was wearing a blue sweater. You know, you want to get as specific as possible. Be like, he was wearing a blue sweater that his grandma gave him 5 years ago. That creates such a specific image and it evokes a little bit more emotion. So when you do surveys, when you interview people who have already used your product and service, you're going to get a gold mine of information and, you know, ideas for stories. I do think it's okay to flesh out a little bit of a story. You know, maybe they didn't specifically say that they felt happy, but everything in there is saying, like, I felt happy because of all the different ways that they're explaining the results that they got when they were using the product. And, you know, and if that's the case, then it's okay to kind of, like, add a little bit of interpretation on it. But to completely fabricate a story is just really risky. Because you run the risk of, you know, alerting the bullshit meter and also losing the trust of your audience. And I think that is just super important and you never want to risk that. So see how you can incorporate storytelling. I want to recommend that you check out StoryBrand. It's really good for giving you super great details on how to build a hero's journey around a product or a service. And yeah, just always think about how you can be Gandalf or you can be Dumbledore and how you can guide your audience to their victory. And what does that look like? Paint a really specific picture and use other people's stories to paint that picture for them. So try and incorporate more storytelling into your copywriting. It's going to make you so much more effective. It's also going to be more enjoyable for you to write. And never be afraid to ask from clients to run surveys of their audience or to reach out to people and grab a testimonial. This is also why case studies really work well. When you use case studies to specifically address common objections to the product or service you're writing for, you are going to be, you're gonna squash their objection, paint a story, have specific details, and really walk them through that hero's journey through the eyes of somebody who has done it before them, which is gonna give them hope that they can experience the same thing too. So go ahead, check out that book, StoryBrand. Let me know what you think in the comments. He also has a bunch of resources on his website, so you don't necessarily need to get the full book to kind of get some of the good ideas out of it. And hit that thumbs up button if you like this. That tells me what you want to see more of in the future. And of course, go ahead and hit subscribe, and I will be releasing videos weekly. Thanks, guys.